It hurt so badly that I knew in retrospect that that was the chance at the brass ring, and you don't get more than one usually. And even though it was in a work area that I'd never pursued, I still knew I'd had it. I'd been fortunate enough to be told I was good at this, that I was selected from across the country to do this, and that I had failed to help, and I'd failed to do well. I don't remember doing one good day on that show. And then as I began to learn, finally, how to handle migraine headaches, which in 1975, Park Avenue doctors couldn't do a thing about. I was given morphine suppositories for my migraine headache. They had no other suggestion. Well, all that did, of course, was make me throw up in a bucket during the commercial. 2 years later, 3 years, when I was doing every day that charmed little show in 1978 for Group W, and we were shooting at Television City in Hollywood on the same stage that the Carol Burnett show had shot, with the same stage manager, Willie Dahl, and some of the same CBS network crew. It was called Every Day. John Bennett Perry and I were co-hosts with a cast of seven. Tom Chapin was one of them. Great talents on that show. But Group W lost its interest in the show and canceled us after a year. During one of those shows, I had a terrible migraine. And there was, on staff at that time, a CBS nurse. I don't know if that still exists, but there was a medical office on the property of CBS Television City. I went to the nurse and she said, "Well, now, have you taken your antihistamine?" I said, "Antihistamine? Don't you take antihistamine for your migraines?" I said, "No, what is antihistamine?" She gave me what I guess was Benadryl. She said, "Now this is going to make you sleepy, but it will help your migraine." My life began in a way. Or I should say, the end of my life was postponed because I was going to die. These wall-to-wall migraines make you want to be dead. So yes, it dried up my voice a little bit, and I wasn't singing so well when we shot the show that night, and I was a little bit sleepy, but you know, you're energized by the fact that you're doing a show in front of a live audience. And that was the beginning of getting a bit of help for migraine headache. Years later, of course, I learned through a physician here of Imitrex, which didn't exist, I believe, back when I first developed migraines. Imitrex, that when I have a migraine, which is now only maybe 4 or 5 times a year, I just give myself a shot in the arm. And it changed. It certainly changed my life. I was in a downward spiral health-wise because of it.